Hi friends, this side, Jenny with you. And today we will learn about the soiling losses in PV system. So, let's begin. By now, you already have the idea that soiling loss is nothing but the dust deposition on the solar panel's surface. Right? Yes, you are absolutely right. Still, it's not that simple though. I mean, that the soiling loss is not just the dust deposition. But hey, still, it's the major part of soiling loss. Apart from dust, bird dropping and snowfall are also a part of it. Yes, you heard it correctly, snow is a part of soiling loss. We will come to this later. Let's discuss about the definition first. The term soiling is used to describe the accumulation of snow, dirt, dust, leaves, pollen, and bird droppings on PV panels. Thus, the accumulation of soil on the PV module can lead to a significant decrease in energy produced by the PV module. In other words, the amount of sunlight that is blocked by dirt and debris that accumulate on solar panels over time is simply known as soiling loss. Just like a car's windshield, small amounts of dust and dirt can accumulate and scatter light. Now, the accumulation of dust depends on some major factors, and this is not the same globally. In fact, region to region it varies. For example, soiling loss profile will not be same for Germany and Qatar. In Qatar, due to nearby desert lands, dust particle in air is much higher than that of Germany. Next factor, for obvious reason, is the air pollution. Level of air pollution is not same everywhere. Near the agricultural area, during the season of crop harvesting, the rate of soiling increases rapidly. But for the rest of the year, it remains very low. Similarly, if the solar plant is built near to a factory or industrial area, obviously a lot of dust and air pollutants will be present in the air. So, it is obvious in such area that the percentage loss due to dust decomposition will be higher than other places. Again, in suburban areas, where a lot of public and private transports move around daily on the road, air pollution is higher there, and so does the soiling loss. Air mist also plays the role of catalyst in soiling. If the moisture content is high in air, then it makes the dust decomposition on PV surface sticky. So, even with a blow of heavy wind, the dust remains sticking to surface. Birds droppings represent a serious problem, as they are usually not removed by rainy events. But their impact is reported as relatively small, less than 2% of total soiling loss. Snow does account for soiling loss. But its effect is very difficult to foresee as, when is it leaving the array, kind of question arises. Due to heavy snowfall, your entire module shall be cut off from sunlight. And there will be no electricity production. But if the module surfaces get partially covered by snow, then it is very dangerous, as it'll create electrical damages to the PV module. In very concerned conditions, you can take it into account by defining partial or complete soiling attenuation during some months. Soiling loss values that has been observed from a large number of solar plants throughout the world in recent years, as follows. 5% for regions with long dry seasons. Add 1-2% if region experiences frequent dust deposits. Add 1% if near major vehicular traffic areas. Remove 0.5% if the system will be cleaned in the summer. 2% for regions with year-round rain. So, to reduce soiling loss, the only option is to clean the PV surface regularly. For large-scale solar plants, a 15 days to 30 days cycle of cleaning normally followed. For smaller systems, like up to 100 kilowatts peak rooftop systems, one can follow 60 days to 90 days water-based cleaning cycle. Nowadays, robotic cleaning is very popular in PV market. So, implementing robotic cleaning into your plant is also a very good idea and way of preventing the soiling loss. PV array with higher tilt angle will also naturally swift off the dust accumulation on their surface. But, if the suggested tilt angle is low for the place of installation, it is not viable to increase the tilt angle, as it increases the cost of mounting structure and, obviously, the loss due to lost in inclined irradiance. Before we end this topic, please note that the soiling losses are strongly dependent on the rainfalls. So, soiling loss is not constant throughout the year. Depends upon the weather and season change, this value also changes. Please let us know how did you find this video helpful in the comment section. We read all of your comments. And please like and share the video as much as you can. Do subscribe to our channel, Minutes to Energy, for more interesting videos on solar PV system. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.